Hey, what it is, YouTube? It is your boy Truth, and today I was sitting outside, you feel what I'm saying, just relaxing. I am in Florida. I know some places out here are getting some snow, stuff like that. Prayers to you guys, but I'm currently very, very nice weather. So I was sitting out here chilling with my son. He's over here playing, and I was like, you know what? I was just thinking about releases that have dropped, past releases that have dropped, and I'm like, mock-ups happened, picture showed, and we thought we was getting something, but we got something a little bit, or maybe even way more different than what we thought we was gonna get, man. So today I wanna do a video on a sneaker that dropped that I personally like because it is in my collection. I don't have a problem with it. But if I was the creator, if I was on Team Nike, there were some things I would have done differently with this sneaker, and I think you guys would agree. So y'all comment below and let me know how I did and what y'all think y'all would be doing differently to this sneaker as well. I'm gonna be doing much more videos of this because it's a lot of shoes that have dropped that we thought we were getting something, and Nike gave us a little bit something different. So without further ado, let's hop right off into it. If this is your first time tapping into my channel, I appreciate you guys, man. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you like what you see, if you like the concept of this video, go ahead and smash that subscribe button, hit the like button, head over to IG, follow your boy at Kingnology on IG. And yeah, man, I appreciate you guys as I continue to try to pump out some content, man. My guy 1127, man, his link will be down in my description section. He has really been pumping out some content, challenging your boy to do the same thing, you feel me? So I'm gonna try to do that. So today, the sneaker that we will be talking about, the what I would have done differently to this sneaker, is gonna be an Air Jordan 1, and I think we first started seeing mock-ups of this joint dropping a little bit around this time last year, you feel what I'm saying? And it was supposed to drop in October. I think it did drop in October last year. So you know it's got a little bit of orange in it if it dropped in October. And anytime we think about some orange sneakers, we do think about the Shattered Backboard vibe. So we were saying Shattered Backboard 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, oh, they're gonna bring us back. We just really didn't know what to expect, but when we heard Shattered Backboard in the sneaker community, anytime we hear that when it comes to Jordan 1s, we get hype. So as the images started to surface of this sneaker, people start creating their opinions like, I don't think Nike should do this. So if y'all know what I'm talking about, we are talking about the Electro Orange Air Jordan 1s, man. These shoes dropped and people were just like, I don't know, I ain't feeling them. Nike should have done something differently. So let's go ahead and turn this camera around and look at this sneaker. Let's talk about what I would have done differently if I was on Team Nike creating this sneaker. All right, so first and foremost, let me say this as I put this thing in the sunlight. This is not a bad sneaker, bro. Let me tell you guys that. Off rip, I do not think this is a bad sneaker. I think it came out pretty dope, but it is some slight changes that I would have made. So let me go ahead and give you guys this 360 view of this sneaker first. If you guys do not have any collection, I do have a full review on these things somewhere on my channel. I'll probably put the link up so you guys can see it. But like I said, overall, just not a bad sneaker, man. Very well put together. But the first mock-up that we seen of this sneaker, as you guys can see on the screen, they did not have the black toe color block. And now when I seen that mock-up, and this was the Electro Orange is going to look like without the black toe color blocking, I was like, yeah, man, I can't mess with those, too much white. But then they did hit us with this black toe color blocking, which was extremely dope. Now, one of the things that I would have changed on this sneaker if it was me, on this back end, I would have put some black here on the butt or some orange. As you guys can see on the screen from the second mock-up, this is what I probably would have went with if I was Nike. I would have went with that, the orange on the back end of the sneaker. Just would have broke apart that white. But if you look at that back, it's just kind of like, it's just kind of all white, and it just doesn't flow with the rest of that color blocking on the sneaker, man, in my opinion. Now, they did hit us with this satin-type material at the top. It's really not satin. It's like just a shiny leather. They hit us with that. I felt like that would have been dope if they would have maybe made this top part where the Wings logo black and then brought in the white and then changed the Wings logo to orange. You feel what I'm saying? I don't know, just to break apart that back end of that sneaker. Just a lot of white on the back end of this shoe, man. But y'all let me know down in the comment section, what would you have changed about the sneaker? Leather quality on it was pretty good. As you guys can see, resale for this thing is not going for much. It's like 230, somewhere like that, man. It's not bad at all, man. So a lot of people saying Jordan 1s are dead. I don't know, but this one, in my opinion, was executed very well. Could they have changed one thing? To me, one thing really would have just set the shoe off, and that would have been the back end, having some black or orange color blocking on that back end to break apart that white. Outside of that, man, I think they executed very well on this sneaker. Y'all, let me know down in the comment section, what do y'all think about the Electro Orange? What would y'all have done differently if y'all was on this team creating this sneaker, Team Nike? Y'all let me know, Team Jumpman. Y'all let me know down below. And also, I just feel like they gave us that Nike OG orange box vibes. You feel what I'm saying? Just with the Nike branding on the tongue and stuff like that. They really gave us that Nike box, that orange logo box vibes on this sneaker. So to me, very much worth the cop. Like I said, resale ain't going for that much. So if this is something that you want to add to your collection, I would say buy it now, because I do feel like it will go up. Kind of like the Ernst Shatter Backboard 3.0s. Everybody was saying they didn't mess with them. They didn't mess with them because they was glossy. And then, hey, here it is 2-3 years later. Guess what? The sneaker is worth some bread. So, hey, y'all let me know down in the comment section what y'all think. I appreciate you guys. Let me know what shoe I should do next. It's a lot of them I have on my mind and planning to do. But y'all let me know. I appreciate you guys tuning in as always. Rock what you like. That was hype. Wash them hands, man. Hey, wear your mask, bro. Wear your mask. It's getting bad out there. And y'all remember, the shoes we talk about on this channel, this one right here, they're just bait. Or for me to share my faith. You guys be blessed. I'm going to catch y'all next video. Peace. I'm off the beat, but right now I'm on the beat. Known to be Brother Moore, spitting for the king.